different with you. Boys never meant anything in your life.
Not after they got a load of you, they didn't. Things get tough, we can always flop in one of these. Gee, I can't get this key out.
We'll try this one, will
you? I will not. I got a dime invested in this locker. I'll tear it apart first.
Having trouble?
Yes, a little.
Well, allow me. Easy does it. Hot, isn't it?
Yeah, but you'll cool off.
Wasn't that nice?
Fresh guy.
Phyllis, sweetie, what on earth have you joined?
United States Army, Angel. You've no doubt heard about us.
Oh, terribly sorry, darling, but we just learned now that we're dashing off to Paris.
Paris? Yes, isn't that a lovely coincidence? We're all in shape.
I don't doubt it.
Joe, I'm missing a couple of books I need in my work. I'm making some tests, you know, testing. But don't let me disturb.
What books, Andrew?
Well, the rubber coating of fabrics by Schweck and Wool in the Arctic under stress and strain.
What's he doing here?
Stressing and straining.
Would you mind running out and getting me a pack of cigarettes, please?
Sure.
Oh, wait a minute. I'll give you the 15 cents.
Oh, no, that's all right.
Here's a quarter.
Well, no, I...
It's all right. You can keep the change.
I kind of think I ought to be here when the play starts.
Well, I'll tell you all about it.
Linda, I want you to meet our author, Gaylord Estabrook.
Surprise.
Give me my quarter back.
No.
Is that really Linda Page?
Cross my heart.
For my money, she's a little skinny to be a star.
Well, it's Benson's money, so you can stop worrying.
Mrs.
Madam.
Madam.
It's my name, not my profession. Madam Rose Petal.
Anybody mind if an old maid school teacher joins that company? There might be a letter from that man I met at the high school dance last spring. Been wanting to marry me ever since. He was a peck of fun. But I don't have time for any of them when they start getting serious on me.
Well, what about Howard?
Howard Bevins? He's just a friend boy. Not a boyfriend. Working over there naked as an Indian.
Who's naked as an Indian?
Who does he think is interested?
I can see that you're only used to the French. In Russia, we hold the hand much longer.
Yes, of course. Well, I just wanted to ask if you'd sing for us next week, monsieur. It's for charity, you know.
You said sing?
Just a few selections, of course. It's for the Russo-American Relief Committee.
Uh-huh. Why do all American women pursue me? Of course, I do not blame you. Your men here, they are so weak, they are nothing.
I don't think you understand, monsieur. It's just that I wanted you to gather together.
Yes, I understand. These men here, they bore you. But this week, I have no time for you at all. My time is occupied. But next week...
Oh, excuse me, please. Papa Gregory?
Hmm?
He's gone crazy.
Who's gone crazy?
Boris Stronskov. I talked to him just now. He didn't make a word of sense.
You talked to him?
Yes.
Allow me, Miss Carter. This is Boris Stronskov.
Madam.
How do you do? But then who is that man? Look...
Oh, is that the man you talked to?
Yes, I asked him to sing for me.
Sing? That's William Gordon. He was head of the AP Bureau in the Far East. Just come home to join the army.
He belongs in front of a drugstore in the Middle West.
Attention, everyone. This is something very special. I'm going to sell this doll to the highest bidder. Whoever buys it will be kissed by Miss Joel Carter. Oh, nice you are. What am I being?
Oh, really, Mrs. Hendricks?
My dear, it's for charity. Come along now. What am I bid? A kiss for Miss Joel Carter.
$1.
Oh, my wouldn't jeopardize her amateur standing for that sum. Do I hear 11? $10. Do I hear 11? Going? Going?
$11.
That's better. Do I hear 12? Remember, gentlemen, you don't get a chance every day to kiss Miss Joel Carter.
$15.
$15. Thanks. There's a gentleman who knows a bargain.
$16.
$16. $16. Now I bid $16.
$20.
Why, you pay that much for an orchid, and you're bidding on a kiss from a charming young lady.
$21.
$21. $21.
$25.
Who's going to make it 30? 30.
$26.
$26.
$30.
$30. Do I hear 31? Do I hear $31? Do I hear $30.50? Do I hear $30.25? Come, gentlemen. Going at $30. Going, gone. To the gentleman on my right for $30. I suppose you thought that was funny.
I have changed my mind. I will sing for you.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry. Did it hurt you?
Oh, no, it's hardly bleeding at all.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry.
Yes, I know, so you said. Oh.
Gosh, I'm
terribly sorry, I know.
Ouch!
Would you mind not helping me up? I'd like to have a few things I can still use when this is all over.
Don't be silly. I was just trying to help.
Yes, indeed. Now just get out of my life and let me forget this ever happened, will you?
It's too bad. I have a feeling that meeting under other circumstances, I would have liked you very much.
Then I'm glad the circumstances were as they were.
Sir, it's too bad.
I don't know what to say. Of course, you shouldn't have done this. I can't tell you how much it... I'm not very good at making speeches, but I... seems to be able to say it far better than I can. Stand up. Well, you're a little on the gargantuous side, but I'll give you a try. Hello, Pete. What? Oh, you're here? Oh, yes, you'll love it. Oh, it's just one gay mad whirl.
Well, couldn't you stop whirling long enough for us to have a talk?
Well, we couldn't very well talk now, could we, in front of him?
Him? Him whom?
Well, the gentleman I'm dining with, he's here now. Oh, no, darling, I couldn't. 8 martinis is my limit.
8? Well, Marcia, you never drown. Look, what are you trying to do, drown yourself? I'll be right over.
Pete, wait a minute. Hello? Hello? Oh, Cleo, get me out of this dress. I've got to get out of here.
Yes.
Well, when Mr. Webb comes, tell him the gentleman and I have gone.
What gentleman?
There isn't any.
They?
The one with the martinis.
Oh, him.
In fact, I make rather a hobby of showing newcomers some of its hidden charms. Do you happen to be down here alone?
Not quite. I'm with my children. 6.
Oh. Well, that's quite a family.
Quite.
Makes it run, please.
Sorry.
Why, Marcy?
Charming evening. And do let's have cocktails first.
By all means.
Quick, make conversation.
Conversation? I learned nothing.
You manage very well upstairs. Say something, anything.
ABC, DFG.
ABC, DFG.
Oh, I do think that is amusing. I simply can't get over it. Do tell me more.
Well, all I can add is H.I.J. Kalemanop.
Not really. Oh, do stop. I can't bear another word. N.O.P. You are the one.